the flow rate was so massive, and that's one of the main areas where we were able to get some data was the Nolichucky Dam area, where the flow rate was more than twice that of Niagara Falls, and well over what the record previous record was in that location. I mean, it had water pouring over that dam, and so just an unprecedented event. You know, definitely not an event that you would typically build infrastructure for necessarily, although dams are built to a much higher standard than, let's say, roads or bridges. But even that really stressed that type of infrastructure that's built to withstand some pretty strong storms. Dams are usually built to withstand what's called a PMP, or a probable maximum precipitation event. And so that's luckily didn't fail, because downstream from there could have had very serious consequences and even more devastating floods with that much water coming that quickly. That would have been even quicker than the water coming out of the Nolichucky from North Carolina. And so we're pretty lucky on that side. But certainly the water upstream from there, just pouring through there, all the debris, just that flow rate was incredible. And we even lost our stream gauge at Embryville. I think it topped out at 19 feet. And they estimate that it probably reached about 30 feet in that area. The flow rate when it was knocked out was 84,000 cubic feet per second. And a normal flow rate for early October is 500 or 600 cubic feet per second. I mean, just, it's almost unimaginable, that rate